عرفت الهوى متعرفت الهوى عرفت الهوى متعرفت الهوى وأغلقت قلبي على من عاداك وأغلقت قلبي على من عاداك وقمت أناجيك يا من ترى وقمت
رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الحمد لله praise be to Allah سبحانه وتعالى who has brought us near Ramadan and this is one of the blessings of from the ummah for the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu has mentioned in the hadith Rajabun shahrullah wa Sha'banu shahri wa Ramadan shahru ummati. Rajab is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sha'ban is my month, yani the month of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa Ramadan syahru ummati and Ramadan is the month of my ummah. Alhamdulillah, this is a great blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not expose any of his mercy of his blessings to the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than what he can expose in the month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, and all this because of the great dua and wish of goodness from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for his ummah. If it's not because of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no Ramadan, no Sha'ban, no Rajab, no creation. Everything is from the barakah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his mercy and blessings, he keep on sending to us reminders, reminders after reminders, and he don't only do that, he bring to us inheritors of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to remind us about the coming of Ramadan, when Ramadan about to come, what are you supposed to do? Masha Allah, al-habaib wal-mashayikh, they come here non-stop. Just before Ramadan, you can see the amount of mashayikh comes to this country, comes to this place, to give us reminders about the blessings of Ramadan. Indeed, Ramadan needs preparation. Before we enter Ramadan, we need to plan Ramadan. Just as how Shaitan, before the coming of Ramadan, they also do their plans and preparation because they will be tight for 1 month. They cannot do any more work. So, they will put their plan, they will do their work, so that when Ramadan comes, they are tight, they are being thrown away, people still do as what they have planned for the people. So we have to be very careful. In Ramadan, we say what? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say in a hadith, "Idza jaa Ramadan futtihat abwabul jinan." When Ramadan comes, all the doors of heavens will be open. Wa ughliqat abwabun niran, and all the doors of hellfire will be closed. Wa suffidatish shayatin, and shaitan will be tied. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued in the hadith and said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates an angel in the month of Ramadan, yunadi. This angel will keep on continuously calling, hal min baghiyil khair fa aqbil. Is there anyone who wants to do goodness? Then come and do it. Hal min baghiyil shar fa aqsir. And another hadith says, fa adbir. Is there anyone who wants to do badness? Then they should lessen their badness. In the hadith says that then they should stop from doing badness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continued his mercy. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? In the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هَلْ مِن مُسْتَغْفِرٍ فَأَغْفِرَ لَهُ. Is there anyone who wants to ask for forgiveness? Then I may forgive him. هَلْ مِن تَائِبٍ فَأَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِ. Is there anyone who wants to repent to me? يعني جل جلاله وتعالى في علاه, so that I can accept his repentance. هل من طالب حاجة فأقضي حاجته. And is there anyone who wants to ask for his needs from Allah, from me? فأقضي حاجته, and I will grant him his wishes. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فلم يزل كذلك إلى انفجار الصبح. And that kind of situation will continuously happen until the coming out of subh. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he always wants goodness for us. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us in a hadith about this situation where the angels will be keep on calling upon people to do istighfar to Allah, to return to Allah, and to ask from Allah if they have any of their needs. Every night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened this door on the last one third part of the night. We divide the night between Maghrib and Fajr. We divide into three. The first one third and the second one third. The last one third of the night is the treasure of the whole night, as how being said by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep on calling people to do tawbah, to do istighfar, and to ask from whatever they want on the last one third of the night. But when Ramadan comes, it's not only one last part of the night. When Ramadan comes, it begins from Maghrib until Fajr, every night. Blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it doesn't happen in any other month, throughout the whole month, except for Ramadan. Special gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has also taught us many things to be done in Ramadan. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us that anyone who does any kind of amal, any kind of good actions from fard, from nafila, from sunnah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him as the reward of fard. And there is nothing that you can do that can bring could bring you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala faster than doing your fard. Now you have salah fard and salah sunnah, and the time is little. What you should do? You should do your fard. Because why? That is how you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala faster in the best way. And a person who has his qada, and a person who has his a person who has qada of salah, and then he wants to do sunnah prayers. What is better for him to do? It's better for him to do his qada. Because why? Because that is the best way you could get yourself close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is the fastest way. وَلَا يَزَالُ Rasulullah s.a.w. mentioned in a hadith Qudsi, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ. And my servant will continuously do the actions of nawafil until I love him. So, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided you to do a lot of nafilah after you have done your fard, what does it mean? It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to love you. There are a few things we could do to attain Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love. One of it, as how we have mentioned, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهِ. My servant won't continuously do nawafil actions until I love him. And then Allah subhanahu, one of the best things that we could do in Ramadan is, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who does a lot of tawbah. At-tawwab. At-tawwab means a lot of tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say at-ta'ib. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said at-tawwab. You do a lot of tawbah. وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِرِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who purify themselves. You purify your heart, and also you purify your physical being. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those people who does a lot of tawbah. And how do you begin doing a lot of tawbah? Number one, you start realizing that you have a lot of mistakes. Then only you can start doing a lot of tawbah. طيب, but ya ustaz, ya my teacher, and this and that, I have a lot of sins. Sometimes I do the same sins 2-3 times a day. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say in a hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you as long as you ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even you repeat the sin 70 times a day. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Is there any God better than this? More generous than this? More forgiving than this? Jalla jalaluhu wa ta'ala fi ula. Alhamdulillah for us knowing that we have such Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ramadan is coming. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has guided us many of good actions that we can do in the month of Ramadan. Some of the actions we can do in the day of Ramadan, and some of the actions we can do in the night of Ramadan. And some of the actions we can do in the day and night of Ramadan. What are the actions that we could do in the day of Ramadan? Number one, for us to execute what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made obligatory upon us, which is Sawm, fasting. And this is the best thing you could do to bring yourself close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do your Sawm. This is in the day of Ramadan. And very important, when we do our Sawm, we don't destroy our Sawm. We don't destroy our fasting. Backbite. Curse and swear. We look things which is haram. We hear from things which is haram. We destroy our Sawm. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Rubba sa'imin fala ajra lah." There could be people who they fast, but they don't have any rewards. Illa al-ju' wal atash, except for hunger and thirst. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection from that. Amin ya rabbal alamin. And there are actions we could do at the night of Ramadan. One of the greatest blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we could do in the night of Ramadan is Taraweeh. The Salat Taraweeh. There's no Salat Taraweeh outside Ramadan. Only in Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made Salah, as how being mentioned by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَةِ. And it has been made the cooling of my eye in prayers. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, الصَّلَاةُ خَيْرُ مَوْضُوعٍ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَسْتَكْثِرْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَسْتَقْلِلْ. The best thing a person could do is to do salah. And whoever wants, they could increase the number of salah. And whoever wants, they could decrease. Depends on their ability. But the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the amount of taraweeh that we should do is 20 raka'ah. It is mentioned in hadith by Imam Al-Hakim in Mustadrak. It's mentioned by Imam Abi Shaybah in his Musannaf. It is also mentioned by Imam Bayhaqi that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did 20 raka'ah taraweeh. 20 raka'ah taraweeh. And one of the greatest action that could prove that taraweeh is 20 raka'ah is the action of Muslims since the time of Rasulullah, Abu Bakr, Umar, when he brought everyone to pray together, 20 raka'ah taraweeh, until today. Haramain, Masjid al-Nabawi and Masjid al-Haram, until today still doing 20 raka'ah. And all four madhab, if you study the number of raka'ah of all four madhab, Shafi'i, Maliki, Hanafi, Hanbali, all of them say 20 raka'ah. This is some of the actions that we could do in the night of Ramadan. طيب, what are the actions that we could do in the day of Ramadan and the night of Ramadan? Recitation of Al-Quran. Al-Quran is how being mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. The month of Ramadan is the month when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed the Quran. وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed something to differentiate between truth and falsehood. Jalla jalaluhu wa ta'ala fi'ula. And there are meanings that our scholars have mentioned in this verse. We will mention about the meaning of وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ after this inshaAllah. And the month of Ramadan, when did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the Quran? As how being mentioned by Allah, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ Laylatul Qadr khairun min alfi shahr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, and we have brought it down on the night of power, on Laylatul Qadr. Wa ma adraka ma Laylatul Qadr. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start mentioning about Laylatul Qadr. And it is known among the scholars that the Quran was brought down on the 17th of Ramadan. It's part of our culture, alhamdulillah, that we together, we come in a majlis and we do majlis khatam al-Quran on the time of Nuzul al-Quran. From Lawh al-Mahfuz to Baytul Izzah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the Quran from Lawh al-Mahfuz to Baytul Izzah. That happens on the 17th of Ramadan. And it also happened during the lifetime of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There was some of the nights during his lifetime, Laylatul Qadr falls on 17th of Ramadan. During the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And now, recitation of Al-Quran. Recitation of Al-Quran when we are fasting, and recitation of Al-Quran when we are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the night, both have different effects and benefit. So it is very encouraged for us to divide our recitation of Al-Quran, some of the recitation we do in the day, and some of the recitation we do in the night. And it is sunnah for us to at least do one khatam in the month of Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Ramadan comes, he will do recitation together with Jibril sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He will do at least one khatam every year with Jibril alaihi salam. And every year he did one khatam with Jibril in the month of Ramadan. Until the last year of his life sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Jibril called Rasulullah to do two khatam, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt something different. Every year I do one khatam with Jibril. Now why this year two khatam? And that is when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew that his ajal was coming, his time was coming sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as how he has spoke, as how he has mentioned to Sayyidina Fatima radiyallahu anha. The recitation of Al-Quran, Imam Shafi'i radiyallahu anhu, he did two khatam every day, one khatam in the day and one khatam in the night. And the same goes to many sahaba radiyallahu anhu ajma'in. Some of the sahaba, they did khatam, one khatam every day. Some sahaba in their lifetime did every 3 days they did one khatam. Most of the sahaba radiyallahu anhu, most of them amongst the greatest sahaba, they did once a week one khatam minimum. And this happens throughout their whole lifetime, throughout the whole year. What else? Ramadan. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has encouraged us, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that Ramadan is the month of Al-Quran. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has encouraged us to recite Al-Quran. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Nawwiru buyutakum bis-salah wa qira'atil Quran." Brighten your house with the actions of salah and also the recitation of Al-Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, "Wadhkur," and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instruct the ladies in the Quran what they should do at home. This instruction is specially given to the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it is also generally for the ladies of the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Is mentioned by our scholars. وَذْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. And mention, say, in your houses, from whatever which is being recited from the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and from the hikmah, which is mentioned by our scholars as the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what we should keep ourselves busy with in our houses. The teachings of Al-Quran and the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is what we should be teaching ourselves and also our children. Very sad. Today, many people leave their children being taught by the non-Muslims without realizing, and they realize sometimes, but they don't take much importance. No problem. We just let those channels, television, let them educate our children. They know every single stars from whatever the Hollywood has prepared for them, but they don't know the names of Sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. It's very sad. Ramadan is a time. The blessings of Ramadan is so great. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in a hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'tiqu alf nafsin min an-nar fi kulli yawmin min layali Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees at least every night 1 million lives which has confirmed to go to the hellfire and every single night of Ramadan. And when comes the Laylatul Qadr, now we have mentioned Ramadan. Now the core of Ramadan, the lub of Ramadan is on the last 10 nights of Ramadan, as how has been mentioned by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where Laylatul Qadr comes time. Now many people, when Laylatul, when last 10 nights of Ramadan comes, they say what? We want to do i'tikaf. We want to worship Allah. Because why? Because there's Laylatul Qadr. Why? Because Allah will answer my dua. Tamam, this is a very good way to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there's still self-benefit in this way of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when comes the month of Ramadan, as how being mentioned by Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ يَجْتَهِدُ فِي رَمَضَانَ مَا لَا يَجْتَهِدُ فِي غَيْرِهِ مِنَ الشُّهُورِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to strive in the month of Ramadan, not as how he used to strive in other months, which is not Ramadan. وَيَجْتَهِدُ فِي عَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مَا لَا يَجْتَهِدُ فِي غَيْرِهِ. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put a lot of effort worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, not like other nights of Ramadan. So now, when we put more effort in the month of Ramadan to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, very important we take ourselves aside. You want to put yourself together in, okay, it's fine. But more important is to ihya sunnatin Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to bring alive the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why do you wake up every single night? Why do you put a lot of effort in Ramadan? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to put a lot of effort in Ramadan. Why are you generous in Ramadan? Because Ibn Abbas radhiyallahu anhu said that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam kana ajwadu fi syahr Ramadan. Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam fi syahr Ramadan ajwadu min ar-rihil mursalah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the month of Ramadan, he's more generous than when the wind comes. Wind. Great hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of thing wind does when it comes. Some of it is it takes away bad smells. Some of it is that when wind comes, it brings seedings to the plants and this and that. And for us, transfer of voice. If it's not because of wind, there's no transfer of voice. If there's not because of wind, there's a lot of things couldn't happen if there's no wind. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when comes the month of Ramadan, Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma said that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is more generous than the coming of the wind sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his blessings and his mercy for the ummah, for his ummah, it doesn't only limit from for the benefits of akhirah. It even benefits the dunya. As how being mentioned by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sumu tasihu. You fast and then you will be healthy. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has made, as how we have mentioned earlier, he has made Ramadan as the month of Al-Quran. The month where he did khatam every year together with Jibril alaihi salam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in a hadith, iqra wa rattil. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in a hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when akhirah comes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring those people who used to recite Al-Quran. He will bring them together. And then he will say, iqra wa rattil kama kunta turattilu fid dunya. Recite the Quran and with tartil. As how you used to recite the Quran with tartil in dunya. فَإِنَّ آخِرَ مَنْزِلَتِكَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ أَوْ فِي الْجَنَّةِ عِنْدِ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. Verily, the level that you will be in Jannah is at the last verse where you have stopped reciting it in dunya. So when akhirah comes, what will happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell everyone to recite the Quran. And those people who has more share from the recitation of Al-Quran, what will happen to them? They will raise higher in the rank in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah. Benefits of Al-Quran in Ramadan, as how we have known in a hadith mentioned by Sayyidina Ali radiallahu an, a person who recites a letter from Al-Quran, he will have 10 amthaliha. He will have 10 rewards from one letter. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in a hadith, لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرفا. I don't say ألف لام ميم as one letter. Walakin alifun harfan. But alif is one letter. Wal lamu harfan. And lam is one letter. Wal mimu harfan. And also mim one letter. Sayyidina Ali continued mentioning the hadith about the rewards of recitation of Al-Quran. One letter. Now one letter without wudu outside salah is times 10. Taib in salah, Sayyidina Ali said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the reward of 100 for one letter. Taib now we do salah. A person who can pray properly and he could stand. But he doesn't want to stand. He chose to sit down. Because why? I want to do a lot of nawafil. Let me sit down, relax. And he's not sick. Then he will get 50. Now recitation of Al-Quran outside salah with wudu. Sayyidina Ali said that you will get 25 hasanah from every single letter. So look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the recitation of Al-Quran. And Al-Quran, as how we have mentioned earlier, the meaning of وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the month of Ramadan is when the Quran is being revealed. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. And is a guide to differentiate between truthful and between truth and falsehood. طيب. From this verse, our scholars have said that what is the connection between Quran, Ramadan, guidance and falsehood? Now the month of Ramadan is when the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings down the Quran. Number one. Number two is that we can clearly see truth and falsehood in the month of Ramadan. An example. A simplest bad habit which normally people do outside Ramadan. Some people, not everyone. Inshallah. There's no one amongst us. Smoking, an example. When comes the month of Ramadan, what will happen? They will stop smoking. They will not smoke during fasting. Because why? Because they know this nullifies the fasting. MashaAllah, very good. And he himself can differentiate what is the right thing to do and what is not supposed to be done. And our scholars come, they extracted an understanding from this verse and they say that whosoever enters Ramadan and go out of Ramadan and he doesn't change to a better person, then he should worry that his Ramadan it is not accepted by Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam kama kutiba ala ladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. O believers, O believers, the ala wa sahlan bil habib hamid, تفضل كيف حالك خير الحمد لله عفو تفضل لسان اف حبيب عمر اهلا وسهلا لسان اف حبيب عمر. Not any kind of son. The son of Hadir Umar. Astaghfirullah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. Oh, believers, the psalm has been made obligatory upon you just as how it has been made obligatory before you. La'allakum tattaqoon. So that you may fear Allah. So that you may fear Allah. And this is the benefit of Ramadan. What is it? What does it do? Increase the amount of fear that you have for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, everyone always mention taqwa Allah, fear Allah, fear Allah, fear Allah. What is the meaning of fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Our scholars has brought to us the general meaning of fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Al-Haddad mentioned in his book, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means the least level of fearing of Allah. The least level of fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-imtithalu al-awamir wajtinabu al-nawahi. That you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with whatever instructions Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. wajtinabun nawahi, and preventing yourself from coming onto things which has been prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the general meaning of at-taqwa, and this is the least level of at-taqwa. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, he mentioned about the meaning of at-taqwa. What is it? Number one, al-khawfu min al-jalil. Is that you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You fear Allah. Number two, wal-amalu bit-tanzil. And you practice which with the revelation, with the Al-Quran. Now, number one, fearing Allah. Number two, practice the revelation. Number three, al-isti'dadu lil-rahil. Preparation for the long journey. Akhirah is a very long journey. And dunya is a very short time. So you prepare for your long journey. And number four is, وَالْرِضَى بِالْقَلِيلِ. And you are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the little that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. And this is the general meaning of at-taqwa. And the Quran is the source of guidance to bring us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to guide us, to stay away from us, from coming to wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala maximum benefit from the coming of Ramadan. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to prepare us for the coming of Ramadan, just like how he has prepared the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in, with sincere tawbah, with good intentions, with happiness that Ramadan is coming. We should celebrate Ramadan with happiness. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. And say, Muhammad, that with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy, they should be happy. So Ramadan is a great blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramadan comes and goes, it will not wait for anyone. It comes with all kind of mercy and blessings. It will come with great amount of mercy and blessings. Even 1 million people or 1 billion people or more than one, even all the 7 billion people will take from all the benefits and mercy and blessings from Ramadan. Ramadan will not, the blessings and mercy of Ramadan will not get any lesser. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us benefits and of Ramadan, blessings of Ramadan, mercy of Ramadan. Prepare us just as how He has prepared the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in. He has prepared the awliya wa salihin. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grant us sincere tawbah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgive our sins before the coming of Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He guide us to the way which could bring us to be a person who is beloved in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To guide us amongst those people who follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again for tawfiq and hidayah, so that we can carry out whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made obligatory upon us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for ismah, for protection, that He could give us protection from doing whatever which is being prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grant us a great amount of recitation of Al-Quran in the month of Ramadan, a great share from the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Ramadan, a great portion from us to be able to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the month of Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the month of Ramadan. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He would leave all difficulties that has afflicted us or afflict our family or our children or our parents or our neighbors or our relatives or our friends or our anyone that we know, and from especially from the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for the Muslims Rohingya Muslims, for the Palestinian Muslims, for the Syrian Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give His mercy and blessings upon them. Give sabr upon them and give them iman and taqwa. And let them know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want anything except for goodness for them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He give us husnul khatimah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He give us husnul khatimah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He give us husnul khatimah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He doesn't let us go out of this majlis except that we have listened and we want to practice from whatever we have listened. That's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ. And glad tidings to my servants of those people who, when they have listened advisors, they follow the best. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those people. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our parents and our grandparents who has passed away, who has written to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Forgive their sins. And Allah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them blessings and mercy, to expand their graves and give them light in their graves. Bring the Quran to keep them company. Bring Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to keep them company. Bring awliya Allah to keep them company. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make their graves as the gardens of paradise. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection from making their graves as the holes of hellfire. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to only bring to them good actions that we do in our lives so that it would make them happy. And don't let them know from any kind of bad actions that we do in our life that could make them sad. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam maqam mahmud. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam shafa'atul uzma. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us to get the share from shafa'atul uzma of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in akhirah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give rida to all the sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive the sins of every single Muslim brothers who has come before us, and don't create any hatred in our heart against them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for qabool. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for qabool. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for qabool. Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.